So in this lecture, we are going to discuss about congruence modulo n. On the set integers, the set of integers. So the set I will denote by Zn, and this set will contain the elements. The elements of this set I'm going to denote by 0 bar, 1 bar, 2 bar, up to n minus 1 bar. These will be the elements of the set Zn. Okay, so let us take an example of this. So I will take Z6. So Z6 contains the elements 0 bar, 1 bar, 2 bar, 3 bar, 4 bar and 5 bar. I will write till what? I will write till n minus 1 bar. So one less than that particular number. Okay, so this is the set Z6, right? How will you write the set Z10? The elements of Z10 will be what? The elements of Z10 will be from 0 bar, 1 bar, up to what? They will be up to not 10 bar, but I will stop at what? I will stop at 9 bar. Okay, so what is the importance of this set? Now let us do one simple problem and you will understand what this set is. So a very good property of this set is that when I'm taking the number, suppose I'm working in Z6, okay, in Z6. We know that the elements are 0 bar, 1 bar, 2 bar, 4, 3 bar, 4 bar, 5 bar, right? Then what is 6 bar? In Z6, what happens is that in Z6, 6 bar will be again treated as what? 6 bar will be again treated as 0 bar. 7 bar will be again treated as what? 1 bar. If you want to know one simple use of this, suppose I'm on my clock, I'm working on my clock, right? So this 12 usually denotes what? For us, 12 usually denotes 0, correct? Then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and 12. So, and what is 13 equal to in our clock? In our clock, 13 means again 1. Correct. And 12 is again treated as what? 12 is again treated as 0. So actually this clock is which set? This clock is Z12, right? What are the elements of Z12? The elements of Z12 are what? 0 bar, 1 bar, up to what? Up to 11 bar, right? And what happens to 12 bar? And 12 bar you treat as what? 12 bar you treat as 0 bar. 13 bar you treat as what? 13 means what? 13 o'clock means what? We say that it is nothing but 1 o'clock, right? So this the actual application of this set is our clock, right? So now what we will do is we will go in Z6 and we will write the elements of Z6 and we will try to prepare a addition table of Z6. So I will write the question now. Okay, prepare addition table for Z6. Right. Now this addition is not the usual addition. This addition is a different addition, and that addition is called addition modulo 6. Modulo 6. When I do this problem, you will understand the complete situation. So what are the elements of Z6? We know that the elements of Z6 are 0 bar, 1 bar, 2 bar, 3 bar, 4 bar and 5 bar. We have to stop at 5 bar. What is 6 bar? 6 bar is 0 bar. What is 7 bar? 7 bar is 1 bar. What is 8 bar? 8 bar is again 2 bar. Okay, what is 12 bar? 12 bar will again become 0 bar. Okay, so I will now prepare the addition table. Now I will draw the table, vertical line and a horizontal line. And your horizontal elements I will write 0 bar, 1 bar, 2 bar, 3 bar, 4 bar and 5 bar. Which addition? This is addition modulo 6. So I will write a 6 below that plus sign. And again I have 0 bar, 1 bar, 2 bar, 3 bar, 4 bar and 5 bar, because we know that 6 bar will be again becoming 0 bar. Now what I will do is the vertical people I'm going to call A and the horizontal people I'm going to write what? I'm going to write as B. So vertical elements are labeled as A and horizontal elements are labeled as B. Inside this table we want to fill our entries. Now suppose I want to fill this entry. Now what is this entry? This entry is A plus B. Okay, so that entry is what? A plus B. So it is meaning that what is 0 bar plus 0 bar? We want to write the answer of here. I want to write what is 0 bar plus 0 bar. We know that 0 plus 0 is 0. So 0 bar plus 0 bar will be 0 bar. What? How will I fill this entry now? Which two numbers am I supposed to add? A first and then B. Means what is the value of A in this case? The value of A is 0 bar. And what is the value of B in this case? The value of B is 1 bar. So I will add 0 bar and 1 bar in my rough calculation. What is 0 bar plus 1 bar? 0 bar plus 1 bar is 1 bar. So that is not a very difficult calculation. Second element here, what will I write? 0 bar plus 2 bar. So what is 0 bar plus 2 bar? It is again 2 bar. 0 bar plus 3 bar is 3 bar. 0 bar plus 4 bar is 4 bar. And 0 bar plus 5 bar is 5 bar. So there is no problem in writing the first row. Now let us write the second row. In the second row, when I want to fill this entry in the table, okay, what should I write when I'm writing the second row? So here I am going to write what? Horizontal first. So here it means that 1 bar and 0 bar, A value and B value. So A is 1 bar and what is the value of B? B is 0 bar. So what is 1 bar plus 0 bar? 1 bar plus 0 bar is again 1 bar. So I will write there. Here I will write 1 bar. Next entry will be what? 1 bar and this 1 bar. Okay, so what is 1 bar plus 1 bar? 1 bar plus 1 bar is 2 bar. So I will write it 2 bar. Now in this line we are going to face some different situation. It won't be easy. So next is 1 bar plus 2 bar is 3 bar. 1 bar plus 3 bar is 4 bar. And 1 bar plus 4 bar over here will become 5 bar. And now we want to carefully write this entry. This entry means I am supposed to write 1 bar as A and 5 bar as B, and 1 bar plus 5 bar will become 6 bar. But we know that 6 bar is how much? But 6 bar is nothing but 0 bar. So instead of writing a 6 bar here, I will not write 6 bar here, but I will replace that 6 bar by what? I will replace that 6 bar by 0 bar. Okay, let me show you as a sample. So the third line, what will be the fourth line? Sorry, suppose I write about this. What should I fill up over here? So it is 3 bar plus 0 bar will become 3 bar. This entry is 3 bar plus 1 bar. 3 bar plus 1 bar is 4 bar. The next entry is 3 bar plus 2 bar. A is 3 bar, B is 2 bar. So 3 bar plus 2 bar is 5 bar. Then next is 3 bar plus 3 bar. A is 3 bar, B is also 3 bar, and that is equal to how much? 6 bar. But we know that 6 bar is nothing but 0 bar. So here I will write 0 bar. Next entry is also important. I have to write what is 3 bar plus 4 bar. Okay, A is 3 bar and B is how much? B is 4 bar. What is 3 bar plus 4 bar? We know that 3 bar plus 4 bar is 7 bar, but in Z6, 6 bar becomes 0 and therefore 7 bar becomes what? 7 bar will be treated as 1 bar. So instead of writing a 7 bar in this place, I will write a 1 bar. The next entry is 3 bar plus 5 bar. 3 bar plus 5 bar is 8 bar. So what should I replace 8 bar by? 6 bar is 0, 7 bar is 1 bar, and 8 bar will be replaced by what? 8 bar will be replaced by 2 bar. In this fashion, I will complete the entire table. For example, I'm showing you the third, fifth, and sixth line. This will be 2 bar, this will be 3 bar. 2 bar plus 2 bar is 4 bar. 2 bar plus 4 bar is 6 bar. Sorry, this is 5 bar. 2 bar plus 4 bar is 6 bar, which will become 0 bar. And 2 bar plus 5 bar is 7 bar, which is 1 bar. And the last line will be 4 bar. Then I have 5 bar. Then 4 plus 2 is 6 bar. This is 1 bar, 2 bar, and 3 bar. 5 plus 0 is 5 bar. 5 plus 1 is 6 bar, which is 0 bar. Then this is 7 bar. Will become 1 bar, this is 2 bar, this is 3 bar, and 5 plus 5 is 10, and 10 will become how much in Z6? 10 is treated as what? 6 is 0, 7 is 1, 8 is 2, 9 is 3, and 10 will become what? 10 will become 4 bar. Okay, in this fashion, we have completed the table. Note that all the entries in the table are what? There is all the entries in the table are elements of Z6. In this table, the entries allowed are only from 0 bar to 5 bar. In this table, one should not be able to see 6 bar, 7 bar, 8 bar, 10 bar. Nothing should be seen. All the entries you have to reduce down to 0 bar to 5 bar. This is the way you write the, prepare the addition table for Z6 with addition modulo 6. Okay. Okay, in the next question, now we will prepare a multiplication table of Z5 with respect to the operation multiplication modulo 5. This is nothing but called as what? Multiplication modulo 5. So let us write the solution now. Let us write the, prepare the table. First of all, the elements of Z5 are given by 0 bar, 1 bar, 2 bar, 3 bar, and only 4 bar, right? Because here we know that 5 bar is treated as 0 bar, and so on. And 6 bar will be treated as what? 6 bar will be treated as 1 bar, and so on. So let us prepare the table now. I'm drawing the vertical and the horizontal line. I'm writing the elements 0 bar, 1 bar, 2 bar, 3 bar, and 4 bar. Here I have multiplication modulo 5. Here vertically also I'm writing 0 bar, 1 bar, 2 bar, 3 bar, and 4 bar. Okay. In the table, in the entire table, on the entries allowed are only 0 bar to 4 bar. You cannot write 5 bar, 6 bar, and so on in the table. Okay. So let us do the multiplication now. The left people will be called as A, and the top, the horizontal people will be called as B. So I'm going to write what is A multiplied by B, multiplication modulo 5 in the table. So the first entry here is 0 bar multiplied by 0 bar. We all know that 0 into 0 is 0. So that first entry will be 0 bar. The second entry that I'm having here is 0 bar multiplied by 1 bar. And 0 into 1 is 0 bar. So I will simply write as 0 bar. Similarly, 0 into 2 bar is also 0. 0 into 3 bar is also 0. And 0 into 4 bar is also 0. So the first row will completely become what? Will completely become 0. Similarly, the first column will also become 0. Because 0 into 0, 1 into 0, 2 into 0, 3 into 0, and 4 into 0. All the multiplications are what? All the multiplications are actually equal to 0. Now let us fill the remaining entries. For the remaining entries, I'm going to multiply 1 bar with each horizontal number. So 1 bar into 1 bar is 1 bar. 1 bar into 2 bar is 2 bar. 1 bar into 3 bar is 3 bar. 1 bar into 4 bar is also 4 bar. The third row, I have to be very careful now. So here I'm going to write what? In this position, I'm going to write 2 bar into 1 bar. So 2 into 1 is 2. So 2 bar into 1 bar will be replaced by what? That entry, I'm going to write it as 2 bar itself. Next, here I'm supposed to write what is 2 into 2. 2 2s are 4. So 2 bar into 2 bar is how much? 4 bar. And 4 bar is allowed in the set. So I'm going to write 4 bar here. This entry is very important. I have to carefully write that entry. That is 2 bar into 3 bar. We know the next entry is 2 bar into 4 bar. So what is 2 bar into 4 bar? 2 4 is 8. So this is 2 into 4 is 8. Now what is 8 equal to? In Z5, what is 8 equal to? So we know that in Z5, now I don't want to always count. Okay, always we will not have that much time that 5 bar is 0, 6 bar is 1, 7 bar is 2, and therefore 8 bar is how much? 8 bar is 3 bar. So I will write a 3 bar here. Okay, because these numbers are small, we can do them quickly. But in future, it may happen that you may get a very large number, and that large number is supposed to be replaced by a number from 0 to 5 bar. So how am I going to handle that situation? I will just come to that in the next two lines. Okay, so the next entry here is 3 bar into 1 bar. And we know that 3 bar into 1 bar is again 3 bar. So here I will write 3 bar. Next is 3 bar into 2 bar. And we know that 3 bar into 2 bar is how much? 3 bar into 2 bar is again 6 bar. And 6 bar is how much? 6 bar is 1 bar. So I'm going to write a 1 bar over here. Then what is 3 bar into 3 bar? 3 bar into 3 bar is 9 bar. Okay, and what is 9 bar equal to? Now that 9 bar, I will quickly divide 9 by 5, because we are working in which table? We are working in a table of modulo 5, correct? So I will quickly divide in my mind 9 by 5. And I know that when I do that, what is the remainder? The remainder is how much? The remainder is 4 bar. That is the answer of the table. So I will write here quickly 4 bar. For example, what is 3 bar into 4 bar? 3 bar into 4 bar is how much? 12 bar. In your mind, divide 12 by 5. Okay, when you divide 12 by 5, what is the remainder? We know that the remainder comes to be how much? The remainder comes to be 2. So this means that in the table, 12 bar will be replaced by what? 12 bar will be simply replaced by 2 bar. Okay, let me show you the last row also. So 4 bar into 1 bar is 4 bar. 4 bar into 2 is 8 bar. But 8 bar is 3 bar, which we have already calculated. What is 4 bar into 3 bar? 4 bar into 3 bar is 12 bar. And just now we have calculated that 12 bar is how much? 12 bar is 2 bar. And last entry, this entry is what? 4 bar multiplied by 4 bar. So we know that 4 bar into 4 bar is 16 bar. And what is 16 bar in the modulo 5 in Z5? Quickly divide 16 by 5 in your mind. We know that 5 3 is 15. And what will be the remainder when I do the division? The remainder will be how much? The remainder will be 1. So 16 bar will be simply replaced by what? 16 bar will be replaced by 1 bar. So this is the way you complete the table of Z5 with respect to the operation multiplication modulo 5.